Every material can have heat energy contained in it. How do we know that it is having heat energy? Very simple, its temperature will rise. When we touch it, we find it is heated up. So we say there is content of heat in it. So heat energy contained rise the temperature. Now, we want to rise the temperature by 1 degree. Do we have to give same heat to copper, aluminium, lead, wood, everything if we want to rise the same temperature 1 degree? Answer is no. The different material with different energy rise the temperature by 1 degree. Yes, that is what happened. Okay, I have got many containers of water and I want to fill up water by 1 meter. How much height? 1 meter. So I have this one container. This is other container. This is another container. Here I fill 1 liter. It goes to 1 meter height. Here I fill 5 liter. Then only it goes to 1 meter height. And here I have to fill 10 liters. Then only it goes to a height of 1 meter. And everywhere, if I put a tap here, tap, tap, I get the same pressure, same pressure. Why? The height here is H is equal to 1. So pressure is equal to H rho g. Pressure H rho g, pressure H rho g. Here the level, the height 1 meter is same, but the content are different. The same thing happens in heat energy. If my container is like this, only 1 joule will rise the temperature by 1 degree. My container like this, 5 joule. Here my container like this, it will need 10 joule. So this is the difference. Everywhere I am getting a temperature rise of 1 degree, 1 degree and 1 degree, but I have to give it 1 joule, 10 joule and 5 joule of energy. What do I say? What is different in them? I will say the capacity is different in them. Very simple, and you are all telling me the same thing. Their capacities are different. That is why for the same temperature, they take extra energy. So heat energy taken by a material to rise its temperature by 1 degree will be known as its heat capacity. That's all. This is heat capacity. So heat capacity of a material. Heat capacity of an object is quantity of heat required to change its temperature by 1 degree. This is heat capacity of what? Of an object. This object, if it is large, if it is small, then its heat capacity will change. That is one thing. Now we come to another parameter, that is specific heat capacity. This was what? Heat capacity of object. Now we will come to specific heat of a material. Here, this is made of copper and this is 1 kg of copper. This is 5 kg of copper. This is 10 kg of copper. They will take different heat. for rising the temperature by 1 degree. So what is different in them? Heat capacity is different in them. But if I take 1 kg of copper only, 1 kg from here, 1 kg from here, and 1 kg from here, I want to rise the temperature by 1 degree. Will it take different heat? No, it will take same heat. Why it should take same heat? Because their quantity is same. So this quantity of heat which is required to rise the temperature by 1 degree of 1 kg material only, that we call specific heat. Now, in case of copper, we discussed it. Suppose it is aluminium. I take a mass M and rise its temperature by 1 degree. I have to give it certain heat, S. Then that heat will be known as specific heat of aluminium. Again, something wrong. I have taken the mass M. Heat taken is Q. Then for M kg, heat taken is Q. For 1 kg, how much will be the heat taken? Q upon M for 1 degree. This is known as specific heat. Again, I take iron. I take 1 kg, rise it by 1 degree, whatever heat is taken, that is specific heat of iron. So what is the same in all these examples? Every time I calculate heat taken by 1 kg, rising the temperature 1 degree. Now, because everything is 1 kg, there is no difference of object, then where is the difference? The difference of material. Now, if the heat is more or less, everywhere it is 1 degree temperature rise, everywhere material is 1 kg, then why heat should be different? Then we say it is different because of their nature. And the nature is given by their name. One is copper, one is aluminium, one is iron. So specific heat is a characteristic which belongs to the material, not the shape, not the total mass, because mass we are making 1 kg. So specific heat is characteristic of the material. And how we define it? Heat required to raise the temperature by 1 degree of 1 kg material. So mass is fixed, temperature is fixed. Now whatever heat is required, that is 1 kg, that is known as specific heat. And this heat, this is the property of object. Here only 1 degree Celsius is the condition. Okay. Now the quantity of heat is given by Q. Right. Suppose a body has got mass M. We have given it the heat Q. The temperature has risen. This is heat given. The temperature rise by delta T. Okay, so for M kg, heat given is Q. So for 1 kg, how much is the heat given? Q upon M. And how much temperature it has raised? Delta T. So for delta T temperature, for delta T temperature rise, the heat given is, Q upon M. Then for 1 degree temperature rise, how much heat will be given? Q upon M into delta T. So for 1 kg, for 1 degree, how much heat is given? Q upon M delta T. This is our calculation. What was Q? Q is the heat given when the temperature rise by delta T. This is, now, this what we call 1 kg, 1 degree. We call it specific heat. Let us give it a symbol, specific heat, C. Okay, we can give it S also, specific heat or C. Now, this equation Q upon M into delta T is equal to C. And this gives us the quantity of heat given to a body is equal to M, mass of the body, multiplied by specific heat of the body and change in temperature. MC delta T. This is what? Heat. This is what? Specific heat. This is total heat. This is specific heat. This is change in temperature and this is mass. Okay. So this is the relation of the heat, calculation of the heat, which depends upon specific heat of that material. If specific heat is large, then for 1 degree we have to give large heat. If it is less, we have to give less heat. Now, what was heat capacity? The heat capacity was heat given for 1 degree, whatever is the mass. So here, heat capacity. If we find out heat capacity, then heat capacity is equal to heat given Q upon change in temperature, because only 1 degree. For delta T, the heat given is Q, and for 1 degree, it will be Q upon delta T. This is heat capacity. If this is heat capacity, then Q is equal to what? Q is equal to heat capacity. We must give it certain name, and let's give it a name. I don't know the name. Let's write it CA, capacity, multiplied by delta T. So compare the two. What is heat capacity equal to? So heat capacity is equal to mass multiplied by specific heat. So heat capacity, this heat capacity is equal to mass multiplied by specific heat. This will be required when we are doing the measurements of heat. There we will use this term, heat capacity. So this is specific heat. Please remember this formula, Q is equal to MCT. Now this is heat capacity of a material, which is heat required for rising the temperature by 1 degree, and how much is the material? 1 kg. There is another type of specific heat in which we don't specify 1 kg. We specify 1 mole. 1 mole. In that case, oxygen will be 32 kg. Or 32 gram, that is 1 mole. Hydrogen, that will be 2 gram. Similarly, every material we have to take 1 mole, rise the temperature by 1 degree. Whatever heat is required, that is again specific heat, but it had an adjective. What is that? Molar specific heat. So, we will write what is meant by molar specific heat. Molar specific heat. We will give it a symbol, capital C. This is small c for 1 kg. This is capital C for 1 mole. Heat required to raise the temperature 1 mole of gas, 1 mole of material, any material, 1 mole of material by 1 degree Celsius. Now it is 1 mole. So this is molar specific heat. We will see certain examples, the quantity, how much is the molar specific heat. The molar specific heat of all the gases when they are diatomic is almost same. So specific heat, because it is for 1 kg, the number of molecules in 1 kg are different. But number of molecules in 1 mole, the quantity, the number is same. Therefore, molar heat capacity is same. So I will make a chart here, just see certain examples of specific heat and molar heat. Here is the chart of specific heat, joule per kg per Kelvin. Aluminium takes 900 joule for 1 kg to rise its temperature by 1 Celsius. Carbon takes only 506. Okay, see the other material, lead, it takes only 127. And here, see the water, 4186 joule in 1 kg to rise the temperature by 1 degree. And mercury, only 140. If we give 140 joule, the temperature of mercury will rise by 1 degree. Now, these are the other things. According to this specifications, we use this material for different purpose. Suppose I want to store heat. I want to store heat for medical purpose, just to give heat to my body. And I want a large storage of heat so that in spite of radiation, I can do the heat padding for half an hour. So I need large store. Which material should I use? I increase the temperature by 50 degree. For 50 degree, this much heat is required, multiplied by 50, multiplied by 50, multiplied by 50. So you will observe the maximum heat is contained by water. So if I rise the temperature by 50 degree, that of water, the heat required is a very large quantity. That will be nearly, say, 2 lakh joule, and that will be contained in the water, and it will take a very long time for it to radiate out, and I can put the padding for a very long time. That is why water is used for heat pads. So you have prepared one answer, why water is used for heat pads, due to which quality? Answer, it is due to its very high specific heat. It can store, it can contain the largest quantity of heat here. Similarly, if we want to cool down something, we place water on it, because every 1 gram for 1 degree will absorb 4000 heat from the hot body compared to any other thing. If we put oil, it will take 2000. Water will take 4000. So water will cool faster. So that's why water cools best. Water stores most of the heat energy. This is specific heat, and this tells us about it. Now, out of all this, this is mercury. For a very small quantity of heat, the temperature will rise up and it will consume very less heat. This is the characteristic of the mercury, because of which we use it in thermometer. If this body has a temperature of 90 degree and I put a mercury thermometer here, first it will absorb certain heat from it. How much? Only 140 joule, and it will rise the temperature. If in case of mercury, I use water thermometer, then what will happen? It will absorb 4000 joule from here. The object at itself will get cooled down. It will not show the temperature because it has cooled down. So for thermometer, why do we use mercury? Answer, we use mercury for thermometer because its specific heat is very small. It does not take heat from the body to disturb the body's temperature. To change the body's temperature, body temperature remain like that because heat is not taken out by the mercury. It takes very small heat to rise its temperature and to show the expansion. Which property of the mercury is used in thermometer? Answer, expansion, thermal expansion. Because with small heat, it expands. And that expansion we can observe. So that property is used, and which is the characteristic which help? Lower specific heat. Okay, this is about specific heat of the different material. Now come to molar specific heat. The molar specific heat, these are diatomic gases. For diatomic gases, it is in the range of 20 to 21 for all of them. For monoatomic, it is in the range of 12.5, and for triatomic, 1 and 2 triatomic, it is in the range of 28.5. When we are studying kinetic theory of gases, there we will study what is the difference between mono and diatomic gases, what is the difference between Cp and Cv. These two are molar specific heat. This is molar specific heat when the pressure is constant. This is molar specific heat when the volume is constant. So in thermodynamics, we will study what are the difference between the two. But their values are same for all the gases because every gas is taken as 1 mole, and 1 mole contain equal number of molecules. So this is all about specific heat capacity and its calculation. So after this, we will study calorimetry. How can we measure specific heat? That we will do in the next lecture. Thank you.